It's Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics, and today I would like to talk about a special trick to avoid two of the birds eating your tomatoes as soon as they get red. As you can see in my aquaponics garden here, I got a few tomatoes and they are all green. But as soon as they turn red, the birds are coming and they eat everything. So that's a big problem for me because obviously I like eating tomatoes. I don't mind sharing a bit, but the problem is here, I can't have anything if I leave it as it is because the birds, they really love it. They are very sweet. They don't really touch the yellow tomatoes, but the red ones, as soon as they get red, they disappear. So the trick is to play with the instincts of the animal and basically to give him some substitutes. So what I do, I use some balls that are red as well, some red balls, and I put them into the tree, and the bird think it's a tomato. So I'm going to show you the kind of balls that I use here. I got one that is just there. So here, it's what I use. It's basically a plastic ball, you know, the one that kids play with. But the best thing to do, if you have the opportunity, is to use the ones that we use for the Christmas tree, you know, the red ones, because they really look like tomatoes. If you look at it from far away, you would think it's a tomato in a tree. But for the birds, they don't have, obviously, our vision. And they really think it's a tomato. So they see this nice red tomato, and they're gonna start to attack it and they try to eat it, right? Obviously, they're gonna realize that it's very hard and there is nothing to get from here, from it. So after a while, they're gonna try a few times, and then they lose the interest for it. And then when you got your real tomatoes that are turning red, the birds have already tried on those ones, and the theory is that they are not gonna attack the other ones. They just think it's not good for them. So obviously it doesn't always work, but doesn't cost, you know, those kind of things, they don't cost much. And if you got some decoration for your tree in Christmas, you can use them and you can put them on your tomatoes. I don't say that it's going to work 100% obviously, but it may really help. So it's a good thing to do. So there is another trick as well that you can use with birds, is to put some fake snakes. So basically you put some fake predators around your tomatoes, and so the bird get afraid and they don't attack it. So I got one that is just here, you can see. So I'm not a big fan of having some plastic into the aquaponic setup. Obviously, it doesn't really look good for me, but if it can help, you know, to maintain the crop, and it's just for 1 or 2 months, then once the season of tomatoes is gone, you can remove them. And there is one thing that I would like to be very specific is on the snake. So if you use the fake snakes, they may work, but you will have to move them from time to time, otherwise the birds will understand that this is a fake snake. But it's very important to understand that when you put a snake into your aquaponic setup, you're gonna repel the birds. And it can be really good, obviously, if they eat your tomatoes, but the birds are also, as I told in the other videos, what we want in aquaponics is to have an ecosystem that is really wide, and with different species. And the birds, they actually help a lot in aquaponics, because as soon as you got the caterpillars that are on your tomatoes, the birds are eating the little caterpillars, and therefore they keep your aquaponics, I mean, they maintain a good balance between the number of caterpillars and other species, right? So if you put the snakes, obviously you're gonna repeat the birds, And then if you got some caterpillars, they're going to grow much faster. So obviously if you got some other predators for you caterpillars, such as the little black hornet that we got in Australia, that's fine, right? But just keep in mind that when you push one of the animals away from the ecosystem, you're going to leave opportunity for the prey of these animals to grow, right? So you always need to think about it and always need to think about the whole ecosystem. If you do something to repeal one of them, think about the consequences, right? So the good thing is that with the snakes and with those kind of elements, you can remove them whenever you want. So if you see a problem coming, you remove the snakes, and after a few weeks, the birds are coming back, right? So it's not like if you put any chemical or anything into your system, or it's not like if you kill the birds, right? All the way, all the technique I use, I never kill the animals. I sometimes try to keep them away for a little period of time, but never really kill it, right? Because obviously we like animals, we like the ecosystem. We want the ecosystem to be rich. So the aim is really to work with the ecosystem and never to fight nature. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's quite interesting. Maybe some of you are going to think it doesn't work, but it's worth a try, right? It depends on the species of birds you got around and what kind of species is attacking your tomatoes. So depending where you live, this trick may be actually really, really good. Here in Australia, obviously, it may work, but the problem we have is also the possums. And the possums are not afraid by that. They are not afraid by the snakes, really. There is a hole, you know, that you can put like this fake bird, predator bird, that you can put on the roof of your house or around the aquaponics. And it's supposed to keep the possums away. But the problem is that here where we are, there is this big tree here, which is a big cypress. And the possums live on the cypress. So obviously they are eating all our crop. I mean, not all crop, but a big part of the crop. So we got some troubles to manage this big predator, but we really like it as well. You know, possums are really nice to have around. They are really funny. And actually, the way we found is that we got a compost that is just around where we put all our fruit there. You know, when we eat fruits, we peel the fruit and we put all the waste there. So the possums tend to go into the compost and they leave some of our veggies away. Well, obviously they eat few tomatoes, so it's still a little problem. So last year I covered the setup with a net, so I hadn't so many troubles with the possums, but I don't really like to see my crop in a net. But anyway, this is another topic. Today I was talking about the birds. So this is a technique: put some red balls on your tree, on your plants, and obviously the birds are going to try and they're going to lose interest. So if you like this video, please share it, and you can subscribe to the channel. You can also download your free video, and see you in the next video. Bye bye. Look at my friend here that helped me to regulate the mosquitoes. Really nice one. I don't know if you can see it closely. It's what we call here in Australia a huntsman. It's quite big a spider.